Hello, I'm Reverend Parker here at Community Baptist Church. Thank you again for joining us here in Santa Rosa, California. And we're here for another daily devotion. Thanking you for allowing us to come into your home, allowing us to study with you this daily devotion so that we can all get a little bit out of it, and then we can allow the Lord to lead us along the way. Amen. And so we're going to start with our lesson today, get right into it. And it's coming from Ephesians chapter 5, verse 7. I have the King James Version, and so whatever version you have, read along with us so you can read the heading. It says, "Be not ye therefore partakers with them." Oh boy. And it says, let's read the lesson together. And this is relationship number 3. This is November 24th. It says, letting go of a person doesn't mean you no longer love them. It just means the relationship is not right for you. How should you handle it? Oh, one. Number one, gradual separation is sometimes the best solution. There are relationships you need to get out of for your own good. But because you have a cord to cut doesn't mean that it should be ripped. Oh, that's good. Dissolving a relationship is stressful, so try to end it graciously. If the cord that binds you is a constant phone call, email, and visit, that's a good place to start. Don't keep going back. Some of us are just so nice that we can't end a relationship and move forward. We keep going back, second guessing ourselves, reevaluating our decision, making it one time, make it right, and make it decisive. Often people will come back to entice you by suggesting you were wrong the first time. That's why you must resolve any doubt before you make a decision in the first place. If you find yourself in a pattern of going back to old unhealthy relationship, you may be drinking from the wrong well. You may be trying to fill an emptiness in your heart that only God can fill. Amen. When Jesus met with the woman at the well, she had been through 5 failed marriages and was living with a man with man number 6. He told her, whoever drinks of this water will thirst again, but whoever drinks of the water that I shall give him will never thirst. But the water that I shall give him will become in him a fountain of water springing up to an everlasting life. John 4, verses 13 and 14. And so there you have it. Don't participate in the things these people do, as the name of this relationship lesson here. We don't have to be partakers of anything. If the person that doesn't, you know, sometimes you outgrow a person, and sometimes you need to let go and let God. That's the best solution. I mean, it says here we're not to keep going back. I mean, phone calls, emails, that's a good place to start, but we don't need to go back. If you're saying that this isn't working for you, and you know, who knows better than you besides God? And so make it decisive. It says make it one time, make it right, then make it decisive. And so you don't have to beat yourself up about it. You can just go ahead and live a healthy relationship with God. Because he says he'll give you water that you won't thirst anymore. And he has given us that living water that those who have been born again, you do have that living water within you. And so we need to do what God has told us to do, amen? And so just continue to just study the word of God, continue to lean on him, because we need to lean on him, and let him lead and guide us, amen? I'm Reverend Parker, thanking you again for joining us for another daily devotion.